best as we can.
Yeah.
Well, skirt, you better be wearing a skirt if you're wearing one of these.
No, hopefully no. Oh, God.
I mean, this is absolutely repulsive to me.
Oh, it's It's got to be a gag, but it's bad.
Well, it makes me gag for sure. It definitely makes me gag.
As soon as I said that,
yeah, but
I knew
you know who has one. The first celebrity with one I heard was Ariana Grande.
Oh. Actually, it was Rosie O'Donnell.
Suddenly, it's not as disgusting.
I thought it might have been Kanye. It might have been Kanye, but you know,
Kanye has one.
Kimye. They have one together.
No, he's got one stuck up his ass.
No, that's
not true. Kanye has one with himself, and they're both up his ass.
You know, listen.
In Kanye's eyes, nobody deserves it more than him.
Do you hear what he just said? And you didn't play it.
Okay, hold on. Brian, hold on. Before you play it, there's a longstanding custom on the show that whenever you get into an expository moment, when you're going to have a soliloquy about your feelings, we always play the Hulk music. You know the music from the Incredible Hulk TV show?
The Lonely Man theme.
When he's walking down the street with the knapsack and he's, you know, sad.
Yes.
And you always start out, when you soliloquize, you always start out, before you do it, with saying the term, you know. We're going to allow you to do this because you are such an honored friend. We want you to have this moment. So go ahead and play the music, and then you're going to start out your soliloquy with you know, and then go at it. Go ahead.
You know. Oh, I love this music. Hold on, wait.
You know you're taking forever, for one.
Hold on, wait.
You got 2 minutes.
Listen to this music. You know, Kimye probably has one of these tethered tampons. Kanye's got one stuck up his ass. And Kim's got it inside of her.
Ooh.
Just telling you. Just stating the facts.
hold on.
Oh, my God. What is that?
Chocolate butthole.
Oh.
Hold on. Turn off the Hulk music. Cut the Hulk music. What are you showing me over here?
It's a chocolate butthole.
Oh. What?
Was that Kanye's butthole where they stuck the tampon?
No, the wonderful Sam posted on our page. It's a story we did a year ago about the chocolate buttholes, where it's literally it puts a whole new literal meaning to eating ass.
Can you be more random?
Random.
What am I shouting at?
You know what? But while you're talking about chocolate buttholes,
about Kanye?
I will applaud you because it is a decent segue. The last story of the show. Who knew that there was an epidemic about people expelling their waste on airplanes? Apparently, this is now the second time that someone from China has decided to take a dump in the middle of an airplane aisle. Now, in this case, it was a Chinese kid who claimed that he couldn't do it in the bathroom, which, by the way, both bathrooms were open when he elected to do this. They hadn't even taken off yet. And he decided to dump in the back of the plane. Oh, by the way, with the help of his mom, who propped him up so he could squat, because apparently he's too much of a pussy to be even able to squat. Meanwhile, this kid is like 7, 8 years old, so it's not even like a little kid. She helped him squat so he could just drop a deuce in the back of the airplane instead of using the bathroom. What's crazy to me is this bathroom's too small for you. I'm 6'2", 200 pounds, and I fucking cram.
200?
I'm lying. I'm 230 pounds.
I was about to say, I'm 200 pounds.
And I cram my fat ass into that bathroom to take a deuce, and yet you can't even get in, and you're Asian? I mean, first of all, he's 8. If he was a fully grown Asian, he would only take up half the fucking space in that bathroom. And meanwhile, you got to use the assistance with your weak-ass skinny fucking legs for her to prop you up so you can drop your Asian deuce in the bathroom.
No trophy for you.
Ben, calm down. I will say, when I was in China, I did see this where a man held his child over a trash can so she could pee in it.
Rather than changing her diaper,
he pulled her diaper down and held her over the trash can.
That's a good idea, though.
Hey, you know, look, it's garbage. It's waste, right? So they're just trying to cut out the middleman.
It's doo-doo, baby.
But apparently it's a theme for Chinese parents to prop their kids up while they go to the bathroom.
So she propped her kid up so he could expel from his fart box.
Right.
In the middle of the plane.
Yeah.
That had to smell great.
In the back of the plane.
Right out of the fart box.
But right in front of the bathroom instead of actually using two available bathrooms.
To your point, she could have fit in the bathroom with him and held him over the toilet.
They could have fit the whole 3 generations of family in that bathroom. They're Asian.
Yeah, they're small. So,
God. I mean,
look, the kid's got a story. What's the weirdest place you ever took a shit?
Yeah, he wins.
I bet you it wasn't the airplane.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're probably right. He's probably had some worse.
Can you imagine? You haven't even taken off yet. You're sitting on this airplane. And all of a sudden, and God knows these airplanes aren't very well ventilated to begin with.
Oh, God, no.
And they're even less so before they take off. Because you know how it is, how when an airplane takes off, how all of a sudden the air conditioning kicks on more because finally they get the whole thing.
Yeah,
up
yeah,
and
yeah. Right? They so, have that weird stale air. Yeah, for
so
the
it's
first.
All stagnant, and this dude drops this freaking deuce that probably smells like, you know, soy sauce and God knows what else he
ate. Tofu.
Kimchi and fucking mugu gai pan.
Kimchi is usually Korean, but
yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah, yeah, they eat it too.
Just saying.
Listen. It's all the same shit.
Arigato, Japan, for being our second highest listenership this week.
Until now.
No.
Yeah.
Actually, we got some new listeners this week we need to talk about, considering we're...
Did they expel this, from their fart box, too?
Considering this story is well run its fucking course. Wow.
I just like saying
horrible.
Fart box.
That's a great word.
He's like, I'm gonna go
that was actually a very popular topic Wednesday
oh,
night.
Oh, no, Japan is on top. They have worked their way back. 38%, United States, United Kingdom, New Zealand, and Australia. Top five for the week, folks.
Who's listening in New Zealand? Is that Graham?
I don't know, but there might be a Kiwi involved.
Yes. No, that's actually the wizard from the zoo.
Oh, he's listening. He's fucking listening. Yeah,
if you're listening, call in.
And no supernatural chicanery on the air.
Well, guys, we are up against the end of another show here on the Crane Emissions Network. If you're going to listen next week, then thank you for even wanting to after
thank
listening
you
to
for
this.
Being a hey, friend. What?
We will be broadcasting from ESB Brewing next week. Thank you to Brian Lyon, owner, purveyor,
absolutely.
Cigar counselor here
no,
at
no,
the
no.
Lion's
no.
Den.
The Sancho, come here.
Aficionado.
Actually, bring Sancho over.
Hi, aficionado.
Actually, Sancho, while you're here. Sancho.
Yes.
We always end the show this way. What did you learn today from the show?
Nobody should ever put two tampons in two people at the same time and tie the rope together.
I agree.
Can we just leave it at that?
I think that's all we need.
That's it.
I think that's a walk-off right there.
That's a mic drop. Hold on.
All
right. Sancho, really? You're buying a new mic if that's broken.
All you Craniacs, make sure you go to craniomissions.com. Check out the website there. Go to Facebook, facebook.com/TheCranialMissionsNetwork. Like the page. Follow us on Twitter, @CranialE. Go and check out the revolution that is Pod Tsunami.
Pod Tsunami. Make sure you check out all the shows I've listed on @CranialE.
And?
Make sure. Check out. I'm going to start messing.
iTunes.
iTunes. Go to iTunes. Dear God. I put the on CranialE page, I put our iTunes link. Just go there. Give us a rating. If you don't like us that much, give us 3 stars, but prefer you give us 5 if you like us. Give us a little rating. Write a little blurb. Say hi. Check out my Miguel Hito Spreaker page because I'm going to do some little hip-hop shows. I got more hip-hop music than you could shake a stick at. I did one this week, and it was absolutely horrible, so I just deleted it. So I'm going to borrow the equipment. I'm going to do a couple little fun shows per week.
A rousing endorsement.
Yeah, I don't know. No, the show would have been really good if I had all our equipment propered up. But anyways, go to that. Follow me on Miguel Hito's at M1K3Y813 on Twitter. I do some crazy shit on there. But everybody, go to cranialemissions.com. That is the hub. That's where we're going.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, my God. I could just
absolutely.
Go
yeah, and he will if we allow him to. So all you Craniacs, you know, make sure you tune in next week.
You're about to say stay with us. I was about to say stay with us.
I was almost like we're going to break.
Stay with us until next
one
week.
One more segment. Yeah.
Remember.
Just stay right there.
From Ben Charles, Brian Lyon, Miguel Hito, C-Squared. Always remember when it comes to the show, question everything, consider anything. We'll talk to you next week. Take care.
We thank you for listening to the Cranial Mission Show. Make sure you visit our Facebook page, the Cranial Emissions Network, our Twitter page, @CranialE, and tune in every Friday, 7 to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Spreaker.com.